is up, everybody? It's BBK Dragoon. So stoked today, getting to show off a few of my favorite trails ever and talk about how to get into mountain biking. A video that's been long overdue on the channel. Also, if you watched the last mountain bike video, thanks. I heard your feedback loud and clear. Many of you just said, yo, do what you used to do and upload both gaming and mountain biking stuff to this channel. And if you really want to, Dragoon, you can go make a full-time mountain bike channel. We'll keep some of the mountain bike stuff here. And I appreciated that, so thank you guys. Before we dive any deeper, a little bit of housekeeping. If any of you watched some of my older mountain bike videos, you might be wondering why I'm recording this not on the bike. Well, I use a gimbal now, and I've been using the gimbal for about a year. It stabilizes the footage, it looks so tasty, but I can't use the microphone setup that I used to, or at least not yet. So for now, we're doing after the fact commentary, throw it back to the trails, let's go. So then the topic at hand, how to get into mountain biking. Mountain biking is something that you could do almost anywhere. In fact, I think a lot of people believe like you need to live in Colorado or Utah or California, you know, all these states that are super hilly and mountainous, and that's not true. There's so many different kinds of mountain biking out there, from like single track to mountain bike parks, to dirt jumps, trail, trials. There's all sorts of ways that you can start mountain biking. The best route, the best thing that you can do if you have an interest in mountain biking though, is look up your local bike shop. Like, this is the first step, is honestly, see if there's a bike shop in your area, go down there and talk to the people, or just give them a call and say, hey, yo, I'm new to the sport, what's a good beginner trail around here? What's like a really good area to go to so that I can start riding? Always, always, always try and form a local relationship with your shop, because knowing the people at your shop is a great way to not only get like good maintenance and understanding about like the right way to set up your bike, but they'll also send you to the right trails, the trails that you want to go to and have fun with. A lot of like longtime mountain bikers, anytime I travel and I'm going to be riding at a new spot, I either, if I don't have like an old racing buddy who lives there or like another friend who's in the area, I'll call the local bike shop and just be like, dudes, what is the go-to trail? What is the fun local spot? And most of the time you're going to get directed to the right stuff. If you're a total beginner, it's even more important because they're going to send you to terrain that is most likely going to be fitting for a beginner rider. So let's talk about the different kinds of riding out there, right? You've got trail, you've got the downhill bike park stuff, which is kind of what you're seeing here in the background. And then you obviously have like dirt jump and skate park riding. Today I'm gonna hone in on trail and bike park stuff. Most of you probably have trail riding in and around you. It's the most common type of mountain biking. You ride all the way up and you ride all the way down. There's no lift service, there's usually no shuttling. It's most of the time either out and backs or loops. And this is the way I started riding, and it's the way that I do most of my riding. The bike park side of things are usually where you have a ski area that in the summertime has the mountain bikes going on the uplift, and they usually have trails like what you're seeing here. Big manicured berms and different ways that you can get down the hill. The type of riding you decide on is gonna inform what type of bike you wanna be riding. There's two main types of mountain bikes in the mountain bike world. Hardtail, which means no suspension in the rear, and full suspension, which means you've got suspension up front and back. If you're doing bike park stuff, you probably are gonna want a full suspension bike. Something that's gonna smooth out that rough, chunky terrain. Whereas if you're doing trail riding, unless you know that your terrain is super technical or really rocky, hardtails are awesome. And I'm a big fan of hardtails. They come in at a much lower cost than full suspension bikes and generally are great learning tools for new riders. You can get away with a lot on full suspension bikes, whereas if you start out on a hardtail, you're forced into making good line choices so that when you do move to a full suspension bike, you're gonna be flowing over the trail like water down the river. Yo, this is Dragoon from the future editing this video. I completely forgot to shout out the shameless self-promotion. Follow me over on Instagram at BBKDragoon if you like this mountain biking stuff, because I post plenty of photos and more GoPro videos over there at BBKDragoon. All right, back to the video. The next important question to sort of figure out is, where are you gonna get your bike? Are you gonna rent one? Do you already have one? Or are you thinking about buying one? Let's start with rental. If you called your local shop and you found out about trails in your area, they're also a wonderful resource about finding out if there are any rental bikes in and around. It's not really recommended to go out mountain biking on department store bikes. If any of you have looked on YouTube, it's a really popular trend for the big creators. Go to Walmart, grab a $200 bike, shred it, and then it's absolutely mangled by the end of the video. Department store bikes, depending on the brand, can be good, but most of the time they're put together by people who don't really know what they're doing, and those bikes aren't generally built for the abuse that you're gonna have out mountain biking. You want to trust your equipment, and you don't want to be fearful that a crash could happen at any point. So, renting is my strong recommendation for your first time mountain biking. Don't break the bank, you don't know if you like the sport just yet or not, but that's a good way to get going. Now, if you already own a bike, awesome, that's great. You want to make sure though before you take it out that everything is working properly. I'm going to link a GMBN video where you can do a quick bike check right before you go out that makes sure everything is tight, or at least the important things are tight so your wheels aren't flying off. Finally, if you decide to buy a mountain bike, I'll do a video in the future talking about my thought process on this. I've kind of already told you guys that I think leaning towards a hardtail as your first mountain bike purchase is a really smart idea, but that doesn't fit everybody, because if you know you're gonna be doing bike park stuff and you know there's a lot of technical terrain, sometimes starting with a full suspension bike can be the right choice. Let's move on, however, to talk about equipment. There's one piece of gear you never can ride without. Can you guess what it is?
You need a helmet. No matter how good a rider you are, you need to have one of these on your head at all times while you're riding. Super experienced guys, they wear them because they know unexpected things can happen. Speaking of unexpected things, glasses. Glasses are really important to protect yourself from trees and branches and stuff that reach in and could grab your eyes. No joke, I've known some riders who've gotten some pretty bad eye injuries from not wearing glasses, so this is something don't skimp on. Helmet and glasses always.
Wear your helmet. Make sure it's fitted properly and that it's set to jack. Everything else, though, is up to you. I do recommend wearing shorts, because when you wear long pants, there's a chance that when you pedal, your pant leg will get sucked up into the front chain ring, and it'll tear your pant, and you'll also sometimes have some pretty goofy crashes when you do this. If you are gonna wear long pants, make sure that they're not baggy around the ankles. You don't want those getting sucked up into the chain ring.
It's so hot out here today, and it can be really tough to wear gloves when it's this hot, but I'm a big fan of wearing gloves because they can really help your hands stick to the grips a little bit better, and especially when you're grabbing the brake lever. If you want to wear bare hands, go for it, the Sam Blankenstop style, no problem. But you can just pick up gloves at your local hardware store for $5-$10. As long as they let you bend your fingers and grab onto the bar real good, they should be a nice option.
When it comes to pedals, you have two options: platform pedals and clipless pedals. Clipless pedals are the worst named things in the world because we just call them clips. Like racers and everybody, we just call them clips. Those are pedals that you actually clip into, and they keep your feet stuck to the pedals unless you twist your ankles outward and lift up. I recommend for new people, just ride flat pedals and don't look back. If you have a pair of nice hiking boots or something that has strong support, like stiff-soled shoes, wear those, but start on flat pedals and then you can move to clips. I've been riding clips for a long, long time. I raced for many years and I still love going to a pair of flat pedals and being able to stick my foot out and get that center of gravity lower. Right now in the mountain biking world, it really is personal preference, like maybe 15, 20 years ago. Way more on the clip side, but nowadays, people are riding whatever fits best for them. And before you head out there for your first ride, you want to make sure that you're taking some form of hydration, be it a, you know, backpack, like a Camelback or something like that, or a water bottle. Additionally, you want to make sure that you have all the tools necessary to change a flat tire. So having a spare tube and the knowledge of how to take your wheel off and change that flat is important. I'll leave another link to a GMBN video showing you how you can change a flat tire. It's a simple skill, and it's one that if you get into mountain biking, you're going to get very, very good at. And really, those are the main things to hit on when it comes to how to get into mountain biking. I recommend talk to your local bike shop. That's the great solution for figuring out where to ride and where to get some equipment to ride. Always wear a helmet, wear shorts, take with you a hydration pack or water bottle, and make sure you have a spare tube in mind. Just have fun, man. I seriously think that there are way more people out there that don't know mountain biking is available to them, and it doesn't have to be in one of those super mountainous states. If you're a dirt jumper or if you're in a more flat area, there are plenty of different kinds of riding we can talk about in future videos, like trials biking, urban, and dirt jump. If you like this video and you want to see more like it, please subscribe to the channel, thumbs this video up. If any of you ride, shout out in the comments down below. And if you have any questions about something I didn't talk about or cover in this video, throw it in the comments also, and I'll do my best to answer. Thanks for watching, have a great rest of your day, and I will see you again very soon.